strategies that I have sold. Wesley, shut up. Okay, I know that's
your one. You're a unit. You're a unit.
Pain is at the bottom of the pyramid again. We know that when we act out of line, in Abby's words, that our child will get punished.
And next, we have Kendall.
What?
You were given the opportunity of a lifetime. Top five. I'm looking for number one.
I don't feel safe that Kendall has a safe spot on the team. Not for one bit. I know there are kids out there who are better than her. If Abby comes across one of them, absolutely she'll replace Kendall. I believe that. Kendall got reprimanded and put at the bottom of the pyramid for being fifth. She went out of order. She didn't have enough time like she was supposed to.
You know what? You gotta quit the crying crap. And next, we have Mia. Mia, just another number. I'm still seeing technical issues. And next, we have Paige. Same thing. Nice job in the group routine. And your mother didn't interrupt. And moving up, we have Mackenzie. I almost pulled you out of the number. You were this close in rehearsal to getting it. Next, we have Brooke. Brooke, why does it have to be all the same or all the dancing? Why can't it be both? You can do that, but you have to perform.
I don't really want my kids to be replaced, but if Abby didn't suck the joy out of everything Brooke did, maybe she would perform better for her.
You're all back, Chloe. You were supposed to dance first. Kendall went first. You watched her from the wings below the first turn, and then you played it safe. 80-some competitions you have under your belt. Figure out what you did in your routine that you could have done better to beat that little 10-year-old at her first dance competition.
Abby made such a big deal about Chloe and Kendall going head-to-head, and Chloe beat Kendall. But Abby still can't even give the kid a compliment.
And in the Just Another Number dance,